I'm Dr. Sanjay Parashar. I'm consultant plastic surgeon. This video is an educational video for women who wants to or who's looking for breast implantation or augmentation. One of the most challenging thing about breast augmentation is to decide what size of implant to use for themselves. It's a bit difficult decision, although many people do have their own ideas. They do go through different medias, Instagram, social media, website, and they try to compare and achieve a size which may or may not fit them. So this video is all about how to choose a proper and appropriate implant size. Now, choosing an implant size is important, an appropriate implant size is important, because remember, the body changes over a period of time. What looks great now may not look as great in the future, because the body changes, we gain weight, lose weight, pregnancies and aging process and a lot of other things. So to make it safe and to have a good outcome, it's important to understand how to choose the right cup size. Hi, my name is Dr. Sanjay Parashar. I'm going to talk about breast augmentation, achieving adequate cup sizes and having a pleasant result. Now, how to decide the size and shape of implants in different type of breasts? Of course, we need to see what is the existing cup size. It's important to take into consideration the desired cup size. Then we have to measure the breast width, which is one important determinant. Then you measure the distance from the nipple to the inframammary fold or the breast crease. Then we have to check the tissue stretchability. And then finally, based on where we are going to place the implant, behind or in front of the muscle. How to measure cup size? First, there is a band size and then there is a bust size. Band size, if you notice, the bra comes with band size 32, 33, 34, 36. And the bust size comes as A cup, B cup, C cup and so on. The band size is the circumference that is measured underneath the breast. And the bust size is the circumference that is measured with a tape on the breast. So for example, if the band size is 36 inch and the bust side is 40 inch, then the cup size is bust size minus chest circumference. Then if the difference is 2 inches, it's B cup. If it is 3 inches, C cup. 4 inches, D cup. And every inch a cup is added. For example, in this patient, 40 minus 36 is 4 inch, which means she is D cup. Now, how do you decide the shape and size of the implant? Now, it's important to understand that the implants come in different profiles. Low profile means flatter implant. Moderate is slightly more projecting implant. High profile are even more projecting implant, and extra high profile is even more projecting. But this is at the expense of the diameter. So a low profile will have a wider diameter. So this is more for a broader chest person. A moderate would have a lesser diameter than the low profile. High and extra high have smaller diameter. So a person with a thin built, narrow breast diameter or chest width who wants a good fullness may benefit from extra high or higher profile implant. So how do you compare the implant size with the cup size? Now, there are very few research on this, but the previous research said that 100 cc implant size gives you an additional cup size of the breast. But the recent study, which was published in a plastic reconstructive surgery journal in 2017, showed that it ranges from 130 to 150 cc to increase one cup size. Bras with narrower bandwidths need only 130 cc to increase the cup size. But people who have broader shoulders and broader chest require 150 cc to increase one cup size. Now, we also have to see your tissue, the skin envelope, the breast diameter, the breast width, and the elasticity of the breast tissue. Now, the key that gives an aesthetically optimal breast is the distance between the nipple and the IM fold should be proportionate to the width of the breast. Of course, there is a standard where this distance multiplied by 0.67 gives an ideal shape of the breast. So, for example, somebody who has a breast width of 9 to 11.5, usually the nipple to IMF distance should be 7. 12 to 13.5, it should be 8. More than 16, it should be 10. And as the nipple to IM fold increases, the breast becomes more and more saggy. Let's see some examples. Now, you will realize there are 50 different patients that I have included here, and you will see how they are all different. No 2% have similar structure. At the same time, the breasts are never 100% symmetrical. There's always some amount of difference in the two sides. And you will see that either the breast size may be different, the nipple levels may be different, the breast crease may be at the different levels, or the chest wall or the ribs may be different than the other side. So this person is A cup. A cup means the difference between the chest circumference and the breast circumference is less than 2 inches. And also notice she has very low BMI. Her body fat content is very low. So what do we choose? A 280cc implant. Where do we position it? It's called dual plane, which means half under the muscle and half under the breast. Why so? Because she's very thin. If you put the implant in front of the muscle, the implant will be visible as external round structure. So to have a good upper pole level, it needs to be underneath the muscle. So it is half under the muscle and half under the breast. Now we have used a medium profile because we do not want too much of projection in the upper pole. So she has achieved from A cup to C cup using 280cc implant. Of course, this was a Mentor implant, which is a micro textured implant. This person again is A cup, but again you will see different. She is more skinnier, more thinner. You can see her ribs here. You can see her chest wall. And obviously there is a difference in the two sides. This is a bit lower. There is a crease there. There is no crease here. But since the difference is not significant, we'll still use the same size implant. Now to achieve C cup, I have used a 300cc implant. Again, dual plane because she's very skinny and thin. But despite that, you will still see the upper cleavage of the breast, which is not natural, but it is impossible to achieve or to not have this upper crease in a person with a very low BMI. So unless there is enough fat, you cannot achieve that. If she wants to have a better upper pole appearance, then we need to put some fat graft here. So this is 300cc, dual plane. Again, in the profile view, it does look good. We have used high profile because that's what she desired. She wanted more projection as compared to side bulges. And this is the result after 3 months of surgery. This is also a person with an A cup breast, where the difference is hardly anything between the chest circumference to the breast circumference, and her BMI is very low. You can see her ribs and her chest cage. Now the important thing you will realize here is it is not possible to have a cleavage which is adjacent to each other or touching each other. And if that happens, that is abnormal. This is called symmestia. So there's always a gap. So people who have less fat tends to see more gap. But it also depends on where the muscles are attached. Muscle is never attached in the center. It is attached about 1 to 1.5 to 2 centimeters from the center. So wider the muscle attachment, wider the crease or the cleavage they get. Now in this patient, from A cup to D cup, we have used 300 cc, high profile in the dual plane. And it is 3 months post surgeries. Obviously with time it loosens up, the chest muscle, the skin stretches more to give a more realistic result. Now the cup size also varies from company to company. So you may not exactly get the cup size that you are looking for. You may have to do a bit of shopping to find the right cup size for you. Now let's say this person, although she has some breast tissue, she has a circumference difference of more than 2 inches, but she is still using A cup. If she uses B cup, then the breast is empty. The cup doesn't fill up. So she uses A cup, but she wanted a C cup, but because her chest diameter is small, we could not recommend an implant bigger than 200 cc because of the diameter of the chest. If I had used bigger than that, then the implant would cross the midline and would look unnatural, or the implant will fall away from the chest wall. So this is 200 cc. Again, it's medium profile because she didn't want it a lot of projection in the upper pole and placed in dual plane. This is 6 months after the surgery. Now this person, the interesting fact here, you will see that the nipples are placed quite wide apart. Now remember, it is not possible to bring the nipple more towards the midline by just putting an implant. You have to do a lift or a make a scar around or cut around the nipple to bring it inside. And that's not a good thing to do because it will lead to a scar which will not look nice. So we have to accept the fact that the nipple may go a little bit more outside. So we will not use very big implant, we'll use just 280 cc. So at least that gives her more fullness and a good profile. This is again an A cup, which is interesting. There is some amount of breast tissue, there is some amount of loose skin. Usually such a person gets a very good result because she has some fat to cover the implant here and some flat fat already to give her some cleavage. So we have just used 280 cc, high profile implant, again dual plane, half under the muscle, half underneath the breast, and she has become from A cup to C cup. That's what she desired. Now this is again A cup, and we have done 325 cc implant, where she has become from A cup to C cup, used in dual plane. This is after 2 months. This is again an A cup. Now there was slight difference in the two sides. The difference was more noticeable when we did a 3D imaging and volume analysis, and the difference was then taken into consideration to use different size implants. So on the right side we used 280 cc, and the left side, which was a bigger breast, we used 325 cc in the dual plane to make it more symmetrical from A cup to C cup. This is after 7 months. Now we see people with B cup. Now B cup are usually where the chest dimension difference is more than 2 inches, and her BMI is higher than people with A cup. There's some amount of fat around the breast that helps us to give a more natural appearing result. So you will see I've just used 280 cc implant, but it has made from B cup to D cup. and this was again dual plane and a high profile implant, and this was after 1 year of the surgery. This is another B cup. Again, the difference you will see is more than 2 inches. There's some amount of loose skin or some amount of stretchability of the skin with good amount of fat around that area. And I've used 350cc implant, medium profile. Why medium profile? Because she already has a lot of fat in the chest. So high profile will give a lot of fullness up here. So medium profile implant, dual plane, and used Motiva. This is after 1 year of the surgery. She has become from B cup to double D cup. Another B cup with more wider breast. The nipples are more far apart, but she has good amount of elasticity, some amount of fat. So I use 300cc implant, high profile, round implant. You will notice all the patients I've used round implant. And that gives a good cleavage and upper pole fullness. This is 7 months. And these results will last long, very long. This is a B cup in a thinner person, but she has some amount of breast tissue and some amount of fat, and she wanted just a cup size increase. So this is from B cup to C cup using 260cc implant, again dual plane and medium profile, and this is the result after 4 months. It's very interesting to see that people from different region expects or wants different kinds of results. There are people, particularly from the Europe and UK, they want smaller breasts. They do not want a lot of fullness. They like some fullness in the breast. On the other hand, people from Middle Eastern region, India, and also majority of the patient from US like bigger cup size. Indians and Asians usually prefer a lot of upper pole fullness and upper cleavage. So this is 260cc implant, a medium profile in the dual plane, and result after 4 months. This is a person with B cup, slightly different anatomy of the chest. She's had babies before, so she has stretched areola. Obviously with an implant, the areola will stretch further. Now if you need to reduce the implant, then we need to cut around the areola. That could lead to scar, and many patients do not prefer any scar on the breast. So the choice is again to make an incision underneath the breast. I've used 300cc implant, dual plane, high profile to achieve this full C cup, and this is 8 months result. Another B cup with more elasticity of the skin, some amount of fat, wanted to go to D cup, so we chose 300cc implant, high profile, dual plane, and ergonomics is where it takes the shape of the body, and this is Motiva implant we have used, and this is just 2 weeks after the surgery. Another B cup, smaller chest wall, wanted about D cup, not very big. So the only thing that was possible, because she is narrow chested, was 280cc implant, high profile, again dual plane, and this is 1 year after the surgery. Another B cup, similar, wanted just about D cup, 280cc implant, high profile, dual plane, and this is after 1 year. Now this is slightly different situation. It is B cup. She has lost volume. She had breast volume before, but because of pregnancy she has lost volume, and although it may require some lift, but she didn't want it scar, wanted a simple surgery. So we said, okay, we will do an implant. We will use 300cc, slightly bigger implant to fill up the volume. We'll do a different kind of dual plane, which is the second level dual plane that stretches the skin and lifts the nipple up. And a medium profile implant was used. So this is 1 year result, which is maintained. And obviously the patient needs to maintain the weight and do regular exercise to make sure that she doesn't fluctuate a lot. This is another patient, although she was B cup, but she had D cup to begin with. She lost a lot of volume because of pregnancy and childbirth. And although she needed a lift, but we decided to do only implant because a lift would cause a lot of scarring, which may not look very nice in this patient. So we agreed that we will correct it with the implant, and I used 300cc implant in the dual plane, medium profile, to give her fullness and to give her some lift. And this was after 1 year. She maintained it well. This is another B cup, but you can see that she has different size breasts. Left side is bigger than the right side, with some sagging on the right side. So we decided to correct with different size implant. On the left side, because it was already big, I used only 240cc, and the right side 260cc implant, high profile in the dual plane, and we used Motiva, and that was the result after 1 week. Another B cup in a thinner patient, but she had a good amount of stretchability in her tissues, and she wanted D cup, so I used 325cc moderate plus profile in the dual plane, and this was just after the first dressing, after 48 hours. So she's become from B cup to D cup. This is somebody who had already C cup breast, a bit of sagging. Again, too early to do a lift, breast lift. She wanted to regain some volume and have some lift. So we mutually agreed that we will do only implant at this point of time. So I did 280cc implant, but here I put in front of the muscle. The reason why I did not put dual plane is because the breast is much more mobile than the muscle. If I put the implant behind the muscle, her breast will still be mobile over the implant, and it may look unnatural or feel unnatural, particularly when the patient bends forward. So we decided we'll put subfacial, that will give her fullness. The implant will move along with the breast and will remain full in whatever position the person is. So this was just 285cc, but it became double D cup, and this was after 1 month. Another patient with C cup already has good amount of breast tissue, good amount of elasticity, but she wanted more fullness. So we decided 300cc medium profile in the dual plane, and this was after 1 year, from C cup to double D cup. This is another patient with significant asymmetry on the two sides, but when we did the volume analysis, the asymmetry was not in the volume as such, it was more in the position of the breast. So ideally she would have required a breast lift on one side, then on the other side, but it would have left with asymmetrical scar. So we decided we will correct it with implant. So I did 300cc implant on both the sides, putting dual plane, but this is dual plane type 1 and this is dual plane modified, which is type 2. I've lowered the breast crease, so the breast crease looks symmetrical and the lift is pretty much equal on both the sides. And this was after 1 year. This person already had C cup. She had good volume and good projection, but she wanted more cleavage and more fullness on the top part of the breast. So I did 300 cc implant, but medium profile, dual plane, and we used Motiva. This was 2 months after the surgery. So from C cup to double D cup. This is again a C cup, but she's very thin otherwise, which is very unusual, where there is not much of body fat, but she still has a good volume of breast. So we did 300 cc implant in the dual plane, and we use high profile, but she still has this rounded appearance on the top part of the breast. That's because there's no fat in this area here, but she was happy. So that was 5 months after the surgery. So from C cup to D cup. Another C cup, but she has more fatty tissue, and there was some volume difference in the two sides. The left was bigger. So we used two different size implant. We used through 25 on the right side and 300 cc on the left side. Dual plane, medium profile, Motiva, and that's a result after 5 months. This is another patient with C cup, but she has more sagging. Again, this is grade 1 sagging. So we decided, instead of going for a lift and giving her more scar, we would correct it with the implant only. So again, I used two different size implant, because this is a smaller breast, so I use 375 cc and 350 cc in subfacial or above the muscle to give more lift in the implant. And this is 5 months after the surgery. Again, C cup, bit more saggy breast, grade 1 sagging. So it is possible to avoid breast lift in this patient. I've used 300 cc high profile implant in the dual plane using Motiva, and this is the result after 3 months. She became from C cup to double D cup. Now this person, although she uses C cup breast, but she has lost a lot of volume, and the cup is more because of the skin, excess skin. So this is very classical indication for breast lift, because she has massive weight loss, massive volume loss, and excess skin with grade 2 ptosis. But again, her choice was to avoid breast lift as much as possible and for as long as possible. So we thought we will correct it with an implant. So I did 325 cc in the dual plane, not in front of the muscle, because she has very thin skin. So in front of the muscle would give a very artificial appearance. But obviously I had to do a lot of manipulation to make the crease down to give her lift. And sometimes it leaves a little band underneath here, like this one. But it was acceptable, because overall it looked beautiful. So this was very acceptable to her. But there are options to control, to improve this by using some fat injecting in that area. And with time as well, it stretches. Another C cup with good fat tissue, only grade 1 ptosis. Because of differences, I use 325 and 300 cc in front of the muscle, and that's the result after 3 days from C cup to double D cup. Another thinner patient, C cup already, wanted full D or double D. I use 325 cc high profile in dual plane, and this is the result after 5 months. Another C cup, slightly more sagging, grade 1 sagging, but good elasticity. So to fill it up and to lift the nipple without a lift, I chose 375 cc implant, high profile, dual plane, and that was the result she achieved from C cup to double D cup, and this is a pretty long lasting result. This is small C cup, thinner patient, but wanted more fullness. She already decided to do 400 cc, so when I measured the diameter I agreed to do 400 cc, but I warned her that in future she may have more stretching or more sagging and she may need a lift. But for now she was happy with 400 cc implant, high profile, dual plane, and that was 5 months after. So from C cup to double D cup. This is a person who lost volume because of pregnancy and childbirth. So she was C cup and she wanted a good fullness because she had quite broad shoulder and she had a wide diameter. So we could easily do 400 cc implant. And she was a good candidate for subfacial because she had enough breast tissue and fatty tissue to cover the implant. So I used high profile 400 round implant Motiva, and the result was after 2 years. Beautifully maintained. This is C cup, but she has about grade 1 ptosis, maybe a little bit of grade 2 ptosis. Again, a candidate for breast lift, but breast lift is a commitment of scar. So in this patient, we agreed mutually that we will just correct it with the implant. So I used 400 cc implant, but I put subfacial to give her more lift. But you can see as we increase the size of the implant, you start seeing a lot of stretching in the skin and sometimes the veins start appearing. Although she had some veins here, but the veins start becoming more prominent. So any size bigger than 400 cc in most of the patients tends to stretch out the breast tissue and skin to make it thinner. So you need to have a very careful decision if you're going beyond 400 cc. But she has achieved good result from C cup to double D cup, and that was after 6 months. This is again an individual with C cup, but good elasticity, good contour of the breast, good thickness of the skin. So I could easily put 425 cc. That's what she desired, although she didn't need a breast implant, but she wanted more fullness. So we agreed 425 cc in subfacial will give her a good long-term result to her, as long as she does not gain or lose weight after this. Now this is already a D cup, although anybody beyond C cup will have more sagging and would need a lift, but there are these intermediate patients who are just about D cup but does not want a lift. It is still possible to have some lift with the implant. And for her, I did not have to use very big implant. I just used 325 cc implant to give her the fullness in the top part and some lift. But I warned her that in future, particularly if she gains and loses weight or with aging changes, she may require a lift. This lady had D cup breast, again grade 2 sagging, again particularly because of the skin type, giving any scar on the breast would not have been a good option. So I used implants only to lift, and I used 450 and 425 to make it more symmetrical in front of the muscle or subfacial, high profile implant, and that's the result after 2 months, and she became from D cup to F cup. Another D cup, not so much of sagging, the nipple is in good position. There's a bit of sagging underneath the breast, a little bit of loose skin here, and she wanted a good fullness and lift. She desired 500 cc, which is usually not my favorite. I don't prefer to use more than 400 cc implant, but in special situation, if the patient understand the consequences and long run, then we do use such big implant. So I've used 500cc subfacial Motiva high profile implant, and there was just after 5 days result. Now here the patient has D cup, but she has a lot of sagging. Sagging is again underneath the nipple in the lower pole of the breast, not so much on the nipple itself. So again we decided not to do the lift, but just lift it up with implant, and she chose 550cc, which is again beyond a certain limit, critical limit. But I used dual plane because she wanted more fullness on the top and she didn't have much fat here. So we chose a dual plane to give that fullness on the top. And this is after 2 months. But what I am worried is this skin will stretch more and more with time, and she may then require a breast lift. This is another D cup. Again, probably the final type of the breast beyond which I would not put an implant, and then definitely would have to do a lift. So in this patient, because there was grade 2 ptosis, we used a bigger implant, 600cc implant. She was wide chested, good fat tissue. She was happy with the result. But beyond this, the patient would then need breast lift. So I hope you liked what you saw. There were lots of different examples for you to see, from A cup, B cup, C cup, and even D cup, and how different size of implant can change the size of the cup. So you've seen that, and you've also seen some of the limitation and challenges. Now before you go to your surgeon asking for a big implant, do realize the consequences. And I'm going to publish more videos, so subscribe my channel, keep watching. The next video would be on C cup, D cup that requires a lift with an implant. So the next one would be a lift with an implant. And then eventually I will do a video on breast lift only without an implant. And you will see how the tissues change over a period of time with different kinds of surgical technique. I hope it helps. Please do write your comment. Any questions, anything that you would like to know, I would be very happy to share with you. Thank you.